On August 3rd of 2022, a new volcanic eruption began on the Reykjanes Peninsula of Iceland. It is now day 17 of the eruption, and in the last several days, the rate of lava effusion has dramatically decreased. Whereas, the rate of lava effusion was initially 32 cubic meters per second on day 1 of the eruption, by day 2 it was 18 cubic meters per second. By day 10, the effusion rate was 11 cubic meters per second. However, when the most recent measurement was taken, it revealed an unusually low eruptive rate of only 2 cubic meters per second. For comparison, during the 184-day-long eruption of Geldingadalur in 2021, its lava effusion rate didn't drop below 5 cubic meters per second until the end of its eruption. Whereas the current eruption used to produce lava fountains that towered up to 100 meters in height, its associated fountains are now more of a weak spatter that just barely are ejected above the spatter cone walls. While it might be considered that lava might simply be traveling somewhere else, potentially a new fissure, this assertion is not supported by the amount of harmonic tremor. Harmonic tremor is a very good indication of the amount of shallow magma present, and in the last 10 days it has decreased at a steady rate. Although the ongoing eruption could last for several more days, weeks, or months, there is a possibility that it must be considered. The eruption might already be nearing its end, although it is too early to be sure. Of course, it is also possible that the rate of lava effusion will once again increase, although in the short term I see no signs that this will occur. In my opinion, I would not expect the eruption to truly be over until the rate of lava effusion drops below half a cubic meter per second. Regardless of the rate of lava effusion, there is a fascinating geologic feature which can be found on the outskirts of the Mareldalur and Geldingadalur volcanoes. On the edge of existing lava flows, you might spot some golden strands of material which are incredibly thin, much like hair or a strand of animal fur. It is due to the resemblance to hair that these features receive their name, being known as Peles Hair. Despite looking organic, Peles Hair is instead a variety of volcanic glass much like obsidian. While dark black chunks of obsidian are generally found at volcanoes which erupt rhyolite composition lavas, Peles Hair is generally found adjacent to basalt composition volcanoes like Mareldalur and Geldingadalur. These unique features form when a gas bubble at or near the surface of a lava flow bursts, stretching the very thin edge of the bubble into a long strand of material. While this typically occurs at lava fountains, it can also form at lava flow waterfalls or unusually fast-moving lava flows. Since material is incredibly lightweight, it can be blown unusually long distances. If you do see a piece of Peles Hair, do not collect or touch it. While it looks harmless, the glass is very fragile and thin, meaning it is likely to break into thousands of very tiny pieces, which would be incredibly annoying to remove from skin. In the past 2 weeks, there has been a definite improvement of the trail leading to the eruption site. Whereas the hike used to involve a significant portion of rugged, sharp subglacial boulders in the ground, it now contains less of this as rockier terrain has been overlaid by finer rock particles, forming a smooth surface. Of course, trail improvements are still ongoing and the entire trail is not flat quite yet. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Philip Petrowski Jr., for supporting this channel.